स्वादयन्निह सर्वेषां त्रय्यन्तार्थं सुदुर्ग्रहं स्तोत्रयामास योगीन्द्रः तं वन्दे यामुनाह्वयम् नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः यत्पदाम्भोरुहध्यान विध्वस्ताशेषकल्मषः वस्तुतामुपयातोऽहम् यामुनेयम् नमामि तम्
स्वधर्मज्ञानवैराग्य साध्यभक्त्येकगोचरः नारायणः परम् ब्रह्म गीताशास्त्रे समीरितः
श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्यः कवितार्किककेसरी वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्ताम् सदा हृदि
भक्त्यन्तम् कुर्यात् प्रीत्या एव कारितः उपायताम् परित्यज्य न्यस्येत् देवेतु ताम् अभीहि Madam Chandamana can repeat the Sanskrit part.
Nija karmadi bhaktyantam kuryat priti yaiva karitaha upayatam paridyajya nyasyed devetu tam abhihi
Govinda Chaswami, read the English translation. I must
sure.
Yeah, get accustomed to your accent.
One second. He should perform all things from his own duties to the practice of devotion, getting them done solely through love for God, giving up the view of finding in them the character of being the means for final release. He must place it, that is, being the means in God, and be rid of all fear.
The essence of the yoga, how do they serve, is presented here. Nija karma adi bhakti antam. Govindacharya should not mistake it as bhakti is the antam. Because the next one you have the kuryat pritya eva karitaha. That priti becomes what we call prapatti yoga. Saranagati. Bharanyasaha. In our case, it's called Bharanyasa. Other is called Prapattihi. Nija is own. English also it is here. O-W-N. Own. From his own duties, karma duty. Adi refers to jnanam also. In the middle, you have karma, it becomes Adi. Karma yoga is the beginning. Then jnana yoga is the second one. Then third is bhakti antam. You can take it as bhakti, of course, the third yoga. According to Deshika Sampradaya, we say that we are not able to follow the bhakti yoga and therefore we adopt prapatti yoga. Bhakti antam, don't take it as the end of the bhakti or bhakti yoga is the end, the final stage. No. You take it as bhakti antaha. Inside the bhakti you have prapatti. Bhakti antaha will of course is a pullinga shabda for the sake of Keshavdas Swami. It's a masculine gender word. But antam becomes the dvitiya vibhakti. What you call the accusative case. That is why the next word also is correspondingly right. Why is it, if you take it as an apumsakalingam, Again, the Ditya Vibhakti is antam. Antam ante antani. Phalam phale phalani. Antam ante antani. Again, antam ante antani. Again, Ditya Vibhakti. The beauty here is bhaktyantam. Swami Vedanta Deshika is also very capable of using such words in his stotra, which we may be misled to misunderstand. By combining two words, one word today I came across in Sanskrit, dānavāri. Dānavāri. In Tamil, there is a proverb. When you donate, you should donate as though you give water. Dānavāri. It is not dānavāri meant there. Dāna donation, vāri water. So that is not the intention of the word. But it is dānavāri. Dānava is demon. Ari means enemy. So the play of words makes us first to misunderstand. Then secondly, you go deep into that, then you find that it is not dānavāri, but dānavāri. So this is what you call, this is also another kind of what you call śleṣaḥ, what you call pun. The alankara called double entendre in French, and therefore the what you call double meaning. So dānavāri, you can separate it as dānavāri or dānavāri. But dānavāri will not suit the context, and therefore dānavāri. But there are situations where both meanings will be applicable. That is where you have what you call śleṣa alankara. Here there is no śleṣa alankara because the figure of speech is not pun here. Because the only meaning we get there is dānava pazari, demon's enemy. Demon's enemy is the God. So God should be protected. Lord Shrimanarayana takes care of the gods. He takes care of the demons also. That is why they are also powerful, sometimes more powerful than the gods. Without the demon, I think I have been repeating this, without the demon's presence, gods will be idle. Gods will always have haughtiness, will be proud about themselves. They will not care about Sriman Narayana. Therefore, the gods also should be given trouble, should be given trouble, frequent trouble, so that they will remember. So this is, of course, Lord's will. So we cannot question him also. That is the problem here. Even when we question, we don't have the answer. That's the problem. So for many things, we don't have answer. For many questions, we don't have answer. And that is why we say, inscrutable are the ways of God. So here we are talking about the word bhaktyantam. So bhakti antaha, bhaktehe antaha, inside the bhakti, you have prapatti, so bhaktehe antam kuryat. We go up to prapatti yoga. So antam kuryat means go up to the end, last, final, get to the final position, namely prapatti yoga, starting with karma. Karma adi. It is not your action can be my action. My action is independently my action, own action. That is why we say each of us must act. I must absolve myself of my sins. Because when we say karma, 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 the first thought that comes out to our mind is our bad deeds done in previous birth. And also the deeds, the bad deeds, action performed here in this path. Both are, and of course, three types of sins and so on. So karma, by the action, by our own action, we are happy or we suffer. Happiness comes later. Suffering only comes first. So jinja karma. then bhakti antam. We understand why we did bad deeds or why we did good deeds. So jnana yogam is involved in this as a middle step between karma and bhakti. And of course, prapatti is involved in included there. So kuryat. So we must do. Here it is individual. Jivatma kuryat. Nijakarmadi bhaktyantam jivatma kuryat. It's an advice to Arjuna only first, initially. And then we have all other individuals also. Then how do you do it? How do you do go about karma yoga, jnana, bhakti, prapatti and all that? So pritya eva. Only with affection. Pritya eva. Again, the word pritya eva will denote that the Lord is affectionate to make you follow all these four yoga. So pritya eva karitaha. That's what we understand. Karitaha meaning is what we call causative form. We have been made as an individual soul. We have been made to do it with affection. We are not to be indifferent. We are not to be aloof. We don't. We should not hate our actions and then do. We do. We do such things. I hate to do something, but I have to do it. In case of parents, parents' words must be obeyed. And then sometimes the actions which they suggest are not palatable. So, pritya karitaha, you know that because of satyaka tyaga, we understand it is karitaha. We have been made, the individual soul has been made to do. So, he directed us to do. With limited freedom, we did. Nijakarmadi bhaktyantam. Kuryat is what you call, for information of all, it's called vidhiling lakara. Vidhiling lakara. What you call in English, potential mood. We don't have equivalent in Tamil. We can say shattam, Tamil, shattam, rule. Vidhi. The rule is there, but we may not observe the rule also. You have a proverb in English also, the rules are more observed in breach rather than practice. So we transgress the rules often. Many times, often, we always disobey the rule. Whatever be the rule, we have a disobedience. So that is why it is given kuryat. Had it been a request, karotu, nijakarmadi bhaktyantam karotu, I think we may have some inclination to do. But when you have a what you call stricture upon you, injunction of the scripture, then we protest, we antagonize, we refuse to. Yes. The command, yes. The command, order, right. So kuryate is a rule. The rule is not observed is many times. A deviation from here. In Chennai, you have what you call Thiruvallur, a Divya Kshetram called Thiruvallur. And Keshavadas Swami was asking every time this question. What about people who have not studied anything? No jnana yoga, no karma yoga at all. No karma yoga, not at all, not a single karma yoga. That is, he is not doing his duty because he seems to be a person, seemed to be dumb. He cannot talk. He never talked in his life. But he is not actually dumb, but he acted as a dumb person. And again, he is an unlettered man. He is unlettered. A village man who does not know even to lead his life. He was in the middle age, and he came to the temple, and our acharya called Attipattu Azhagesinghar. He was the 38th pontiff. We saw him coming into the temple. And the history of the Kshetram is very long, but I will put it in one line. One of the devotees of the Lord gave Vaidya Veeraraghava, Dr. Veeraraghava Swami, a shawl to cover himself for the cold. While he was sleeping in the bed, he gave an extra, blanket. That blanket is called Palli Tuppatti. Tuppatti, madam knows, Tuppatti means the towel like, of course, a little bigger in size. And you can use it for drying yourself after bath. Bath towel, and it can be used as angavastra, the upper garment. So many uses for tuppatti. It's called Palli Tuppatti. Palli Tuppatti is a low quality tuppatti, and it is available only in villages. Sometimes it is old, torn, and so on. Rag is like a rag. The poor devotee could offer only to the Lord this kind of. This uneducated man came into the temple, shouted toward the Lord, "He is asking me to come with the Palli Tuppatti." Then he passed away there. Immediately fell down and the life ebbed out. Azhagesinghar saw this. How did he know what is Palli Tuppatti? He does not know what is Palli Tuppatti. He never studied the history, knew the history of the temple. So it was long ago. This history happened long ago, the historical incident. And therefore, he saw with his own eyes. Meaning, of course, we have to of course believe the incident in order to understand the efficacy of the Lord Vaidya Veeraraghava to bless us with the boon of getting married soon, number one, begetting an issue, number two, number three, moksha. So all these three are removing the diseases. Removing the diseases, and the fourth one is moksha. So all the four, dharma, artha, kama, one like that. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. So getting married becomes what we call dharma. I won't call it kama or artha. So begetting an issue again, dharma. Prajayai grihamedhinam is one of the qualities of the solar kings of solar race. Raghuvamsam, Kalidasa says, Prajayai Grihamedina. They married for children. That means they are not for any other aim. Getting married is not for some other aim. Dasaratha's mother died at the early age of Dasaratha, at the age of 10. At the age of 10, mother passed away. That was a rather bad miracle. Aja went to the forest. Indumati died of peculiar nemesis. And then Aja went to the forest. And Dasaratha was interested with the kingdom of Ayodhya. Kosala kingdom of Ayodhya. Ayodhya was the capital city, and Dasaratha became king at the age of 10. Why I say this is, such things happen, and here the point is, Karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga, prapatti yoga are not adoptable by some people. But in spite of it, you get dharma, artha, kama and moksha. But here kuriyata is a rule. Kuriyata is a rule for any normal human being who is capable of thinking should do that. Should, with all facility. With all facility. So kuriyata pritya eva. With a lot of interest, deep interest. As we do for the main ancestor, Shraddham. Shraddham is called Shraddhaya Kritam Shraddham. Only with a deep interest, faith and so on, we do that. So, Pritya Eva Karita. Upayatam, Upayatam Paritya. Now this is what we have been insisting for a long time from the beginning. There are two types of upayas. One is major and the other is minor. Major upaya, normal rather, more important means is Lord Sriman Narayana, and minor upayas are is karma, jnana, bhakti and prapatti yoga. So remember, don't entertain the thought that your karma yoga, your jnana yoga, your bhakti yoga, and your prapatti yoga are helping you to get the moksha. No. So these are all only minor upayas. The what we call the very important strategy, method of approach to Lord is the Lord himself. Kulashekhar Advar says it in Mukundamala. Vishnu Poto Naranam. For all human beings, for all individual souls, Jivatmas, he is the boat, B-O-A-T, Potaha, Sanskrit. Potaha, boat, B-O-A-T, boat, ship. So to cross the ocean of life, Bhava Jaladhikatanam Dvanda Vatahatanam Sutta Duhitru Kalatra Trana Bharadhitanam Vishama Vishayatoye Majjataham Aplavanam Bhavatu Sharanameko Vishnu Poto Naranam. Very easy to understand for all Govindacharya included. Why I say this? The words are very simple. Kulashekhara was a king. He was a king. He was a king in simple sense. That is why Bhava Jaladhi Gatanam. We are all immersed in an ocean. Drowned actually. We are all drowned in the ocean of life. Bhava, life. Jaladhi, ocean, jalam, water, jaladhi, ocean, gatana. We are deep into the ocean. We are not able to come up. We are not able to save our lives. Bhava jaladhi gatana. Why? Because we are all tossed by the waves called opposite paths. Opposite paths. Bhagavad Gita says, labha labho, jaya jayo, dukha dukhe. There are three opposite paths. Happiness and sadness, sukha dukkhe, labaha alabaha, profit and loss, labha labha, jayaha victory, ajayaha defeat, so victory and defeat. These opposite paths always affect us in our life. Dvanda vataha tanam, there is a tornado in the sea. There is a tsunami in the sea that affects us. We are in the sea of life, drowned in the ocean of life, and it's a water grave. It's a water grave. Life is a water grave. So, dvanda vata hatana, vata, vata, hurricane. We are affected by it. Ahatana, we are beaten. We are beat, we can say B-E-A-T. Beat by the waves, dvanda vatahatana, by the wind, windy waves, wavy winds, dvanda vatahatana. So who are then? We are now pulled down by the burden of responsibility. Suta, duhitru, kalatra, Trana, Bhara, Ardhitana. We are suffering by the issues, son, daughter, wife, Sutta, Duhitru, Kalatra. Because Kulasekhar Alvar was a man, he was talking about like this. Generally, it means all. So what are your friends also, your relatives, all your relatives, including. So Sutta, son, Duhitru, daughter, Kalatra, wife, Bhara, taking the responsibility of protecting them, Ardhitana, we are all suffering. So we have to earn, we have to keep them happy, keep them safe, secure, so many things. Online classes, the parents should be with the children 24 hours. They cannot do any other work. They'll have to sit with the children in online class because children cannot understand what is going on. The online classes. So here, so Trana Bharardhitana, Trana protection, Bhara responsibility, weight, burden, Ardhitana suffering. Vishama Vishaya Toya. The water is also mischievous. Vishama Vishaya Toya. Vishama. So there are so many distractions also. So many objects of pleasure in this world which move us away, wean us away from the Lord. Vishama Vishaya Toya. Majjatam Aplavana. It is like a flash flood. We go into it and then we are not able to come out. Majjatam Aplavana. Only one refuge is there. Shelter is there. Bhavatu Sharanam Ekaha. Bhavatu Sharanam. There is only one refuge. Only succor. One protector. Namely, Vishnupoto Narana. Only one boat is there to cross the entire ocean of life. Now this is what we say, karma yo karma adi bhaktyantam kuryate prityeva karitaha. Pritya eva karitaha. Only one aspect is there, namely affection. Without our affection, he will not budge. He will not bless. He will not favor. So upayatam parityajya. So give up all your thought that these four are the means to reach him. Then what do you do? Last word that you get in Charma Sloka, Ma Suchaha. Don't worry. That is what here we have. Abhihi. Abhihi. Without fear. Fearlessly. Abhihi. Tam nyasyet deve. Upayatam tam nyasyet deve. Tu is for stress. You have a great stress upon the point, idea, namely. Whatever you want to do it. This is what Govindacharya says, Swami. Nyasyet is prapatyoga. Nyasyet. So believe in him. Have faith in him. Mahavishwasaha. Great faith in him. Already go through the varanam. The faith that he will protect you. Rakshishyati. Go through the varanam is he is the protector. We don't have any other protector. Savior. He, what I mean to say is, Rakshakaha. Rakshakaha. So here you have Goptrutvarana, Gopta. He is the Gopta. So Upayatam Parityajya, give up the thought that these three, because I did my duties, because I gained wisdom by reading books and approaching preceptors, and then I understood what I am doing. Karma, and I also I am devoted. My devotion is very high, great. And with all this, nothing can be done. So upayatam parityajya. So give up parityajya. After giving up, nyasyet deve, who is that deve in the Lord, that means unto the Lord Sriman Narayana, he is the only Lord. Nyasyet, place your upayata thought, place your the thought of means, or who is the means, to generally means, but here it means sister, deve tu, that means ananya bhakti hi, ananya sadharana bhakti hi. You can also say ananya takatvam, don't go to any other god. Tam upayatam nyasyate, remember that you tell him that directly, you are my means to reach you. You are the only succor, only refuge, only shelter, only method of approach to reach yourself. But do it without fear. Abhi. It's a very beautiful small word. Abhi. Bihi. Bhimasenaha. You heard of Bhimasenaha. Vibhishanaha. Ravana's younger brother. Vibhishanaha. He will threaten everybody. Threaten heavily. He will threaten everybody heavily. He is not an ordinary warrior. He is a very good fighter, just like Ravana, elder brother. So here, Bhimasena, looking at his personality, everybody will be afraid. Bhimaha is a threatening man. Abhihi. But here we don't have any fear. Fear in the sense, no hesitation, no shyness, no reservation, and that is called no fear. Vedanta Deshika wrote Abhitistava, 33 verses, how to avoid fear. He laid himself as one of the corpses in the demolition of the temple by the invaders. He remained still among the corpses, and then he saved Ranganatha. The fear also, the fear psychosis makes us even die. He did not die. Because he did not have fear. Abhi. So we have concrete live examples. Ramanujacharya was given poison in the food by somebody, by some, I think it should be lady, encouraged by somebody, bad person. Ramanujacharya was offered poisonous food. Such things happen in the life of great people. But again, they were not afraid of. And that is what it was. So, should we go to the commentary, or we can have some other?
Well, if you want to go to the commentaries, otherwise we can ask a question. I can make some comments. So this verse, to me, this is another translation of Krishna Charma Sloka.
Right.
It's actually even better than Krishna Charma Sloka, because in my opinion. Because he's very, very clearly lays out, it says, first of all, starting with karma and ending with bhakti, all these things, all these upayas have to be given up.
And while the word given up should be given up, must be taken very carefully, because you should not give up your karma, but upayatam only. Don't think of your action as a means only, that's all.
Right.
Let us not take our wisdom as the upaya, but you cannot remain idle without gaining wisdom.
Right, but it's very clear that the word kuryat in Vidhi Lin, is in the Vidhi from kuryat. This is showing he's commanding us to do these things. But then at the end you get you also get karitaha. Karitaha shows that it's done by him. So the sattvika tyaga is there in this sloka also. Kuryat and karitaha represent the sattvika tyaga.
Right.
Limited freedom
of the individual soul, direction by the supreme soul.
Right. I have a question though. Your explanation about abhihi being fearlessness, it's a masuchaha equals to masuchaha in Charmasloka. And Deve, when Krishna says unto me alone, mam ekam sharanam vaja. And two, mam ekam is equal to two. So this, but Deve is in locative saptami vibhakti,
right?
And somewhere I was reading that sometimes saptami vibhakti is used for affection. Is it correct?
Saptami, adhikarane saptami is the rule. Adhikaranam is the saptami is the rule. It's called the substratum. A personality to reckon with. One can say, but the pritya is there already. Pritya is
or a pritya is mentioned anyway, so we don't need to add that. Okay, all right, good. So I really like this, and I'm trying. It seems to me that if I didn't know it any better, I would think this is the last sloka, because it seems to be like a charma sloka for Gita Artha Sangraha.
Right.
So I'm now wondering what can come after this, because this is everything.
It's only what you call conclusion. Next one will be the conclusion.
Next one will be the conclusion. But sometimes, even in Bhagavad Gita, there's a few verses after charma sloka. So, but I'm thinking this is, to me, this is most important verse I've seen in Gita Artha Sangraha so far, because it gives the synonymous meaning of Krishna Charma Sloka. It's very, very nice.
So page 117, evam idasya adhikarinaha. Evam idasya meaning this type of. We are talking about the plural, adhikarinaha. Or if it is sapta, shakti, vakti, you must understand. Adhikari is what we call the individual soul who has to do kuryat, who is to do kuryat, karmadi bhagavat bhaktyantam, pritya eva, karitaha, kuryat. That is called adhikari. Evam vidasya adhikari. Evam vidasya. Again, we must say, upayatam parityajya, that type of person. Upayatam parityajya, nyasyet. You can take it here as yaha nyasyati, yaha upayatam parityajya karma, jnana, bhakti, prapatti, yogeshu. Upayatam chintam parityajya. Giving up the thought. Pritya eva deve tu yaha nyasyati saha adhikari. The Sanskrit way of saying. So evam idasya adhikarinaha. The rightful person who did this way. So what does he follow? Satatam kirtayantaha mam. Very difficult to have 24/7 kirtanam. Already we saw Kirtanayi. Sing the names. Sing the name. Not utter the name, sing the name. So Satatam always Mam Kirtayantaha. These people, Adhikarna is in plural now, Bahuvachan. So they always recite my name. They always sing my name. Kirtayantaha Mam. Bhajanam we say in Sanskrit. Bhajan we say Hindi. Bhajanam is touching. So touching the Lord with our heart. So Satatam always Kirtayantaha Mam. Gita 9th chapter 14th verse. Iti upta prakriyaya. Thus said, iti thus said upta prakriyaya, the procedure has been said. How do we go about bhakti yoga? Even karma yoga. Karma yoga, you take what you call symbols. C-Y-M-B-O-L-S. So symbols, what you call jalra. And then tap it for music. And then sing, start singing. In a mass prayer. And so because there are many people together. They have gathered together and then they are singing. Here iti upta prakriyaya with the procedure adopted like this. So karma yoga always, karma yoga involves your mouth to sing the name. Mouth is a sense organ to sing the name. Tongue is this organ to sing the name. And so karmendriya, karma is used there. So jnana, you know how to sing, how to give a pass, how to sing the ragas, tunes. Musical knowledge is there. So jnana yoga is there. Then bhakti yoga is there. You understand the meanings of the words when you sing. And therefore, all these are included. Then varnashrama dharmanam api lopaha syat iti atra. Now this is a question. When we sing the names of the Lord, do we forget our duties? That is the duties in the sense, again, according to the caste system, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. Then Brahmacharya, Garhastya, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa, Ashrama. So Varnashrama Dharmanam Api Lopaha Syatu. So if all of us are going on singing the names of the Lord, what should we do about our duties? That means we will drop our duties. We will not, if you sing 24/7, we will not do any other action. So api lopaha, so dharmanam api. Sometimes we don't even take food. That's why api is there. Varnashrama dharmanam, it is also necessary that we must take food also. On Ekadashi day, you must not take food. That is also. So varnashrama dharma, that is also a dharma. Varna dharma and ashrama dharma. The sannyasi's ashrama dharma is to take very little, very much less food. He cannot take anything and everything at any time. So lobaha syat, there will be a lacuna. There will be a what you call drop. So drop of karma yoga. Then iti syat, maybe, syat, maybe. Iti, thus, atra, here, aha said. What is nija karmadi? We saw Nijakarmadi in the Gita Sangraha Sloka. So what is own action? How do you call an action own? Nijakarmadi meaning individual action. It is not a collective action. Collective action is singing of the names, Kirtanam. Other is called Bhajanam. Other is called here, what you call, we saw the earlier word again, Kirtanayi. Singing the name. So nija karma iti, thus being called own action. So kirta yantaha we saw in plural. So all people are doing it. And many people are doing this kirtanam, repetition of names by singing, then how do you call one's own action? Everybody is doing it. So it is not, it's a common action. So how do you call it nijakarma? Nijakarmeti, meaning nitya dasya eka svabhavasya. So while we do this, while all of us together do the singing, we must find, remember that we are all permanent servants. Nitya dasyam. Our slavery is forever. Nitya dasyam. That is the only emotion that we must have. That is the only nature, original nature we must have. Eka svabhava. Nitya dasyika svabhava. Now, please remember this, for just for humor, I tell you. People come together for singing Radha Kalyanam, Rukmini Kalyanam, Sita Kalyanam, all this there. Then I catch up the mic. I'm the leader of the group. Then I catch up the mic and I don't give the mic to anyone else. Go on singing till my throat pains. I think that I know singing better than anybody else. I know many songs other better than anybody else. So the problem of what you call pride, haughtiness, all these words, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, matsarya, all the six enemies haunt us, attack us from within the body. And therefore, we get proud, we expect others to praise me. And then, so this all happens in our collective singing. And therefore, they must avoid that. And therefore, while you avoid that, you remember that you are a slave, permanent slave. Nitya dasya eka svabhavasya. Nitya dasya eka svabhavasya. If you are ready to sing at the last, then you will be the best person. It is not you are putting up a show that you know how to sing. So nitya dasya eka svabhavasya. Then muktasya eva. You are like a released soul. Muktasya eva asya api. So just like a released soul always feel slavish. Or feel slavishness in him towards the Lord, then asyapi, that is asyapi means an individual soul who is living in this world. Here now we are referring to the adhikari which we have now, namely in the individual soul. Tat parichananam. So singing of the names of the Lord is to be remembered as a service to the Lord. I'm singing, I know how to sing, I know the names, lot of names, I understand the names better than others. I know the deep meaning of the old names. Because while you know, while we sing, we remember the gunam, gunakirtanam. Gunakirtanam is more important. When we sing the qualities of the Lord, when we praise the Lord, remember that we become happy on knowing that He has unlimited auspicious quality. And therefore, that will be tat paricharana. So we must feel that we are humble, we are devoted, we are serving the Lord by singing. So because one of the nine types of bhakti, that is what we call shravanam kirtanam. Second step is shravanam kirtanam. So tat paricharanam. Paricharanam, serving at the feet is more important. Tat paricharanam. Then tat ajnanu vartana. Don't transgress the rules of scriptures. Shrutihi eva mama ajna. He says in Bhagavad Gita. Scriptures are my orders. Carry them out. Obey them. Don't disobey. Don't transgress those rules. So, tadajna, his order, anuvartanam, follow. follow up of his order. His orders are Vedic order, scriptural order. How do you do it? Prityayev. Again, remember the Gita Sangraha word, the second quarter. So Prityayeva Karitaha. Of course, we remember that the Lord himself, Sriman Narayana himself, makes us so good in the sense that makes us feel the affection towards the Lord. Because Lord has shown his affection towards us, we also ought to be grateful, and because of our grateful acknowledgement, we are able to love him, and that is called priti. Then anuvartana prityayeva. Then yatha shastram. If you don't know scriptures, follow Ramayana. If you can go up a higher level, read Smritis, read Dharma Shastra. Or if you want to be lawyer, come to Mahabharata and understand. Mahabharata panchamo Veda. The fifth scripture is Mahabharata. And if you can go higher, read Upanishads. Read Upanishads and understand the principles. Brihadaranyaka Upanishad says, today's discussion, Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avashishyate. That is what we now understood through the word. Jivatma is Anu. Jivatma is atomic in nature. Anuttam Nama, what is the meaning of the word atomic in nature? The word atomic in nature, referring to the individual soul, has got a quality called Pratihata Anarhatvam. So it's a little difficult word to understand. Pratihata Anarhatvam means Lord Sivan Narayana, as the Supreme Soul, becomes the inner soul inside the Anu, namely individual soul. The problem will be discussed later, but just to indicate why is the problem, why is a problem, because of our misunderstanding. The problem is Anu meaning atomic in nature. Anu means smallest or tiniest object, a tiny object. Remember, as far as possible, what will be your imagination of tiniest object. Now, within this tiniest object, Lord resides as a inner soul. The problem here in definition is, Anu has the word atom, referring to the individual, has no limbs, no avayavaham, avayavam, no avayavam. Anuttam nama avayava rahitam. There is no avayava for the limbs for the Anu. Then if you have no limbs for the Anu, meaning that no body for the Anu, then where is the space for the Lord to go into? This is our narrow-minded vision. Because we do not understand. Then how do you understand? There are so many aspects. We say, Lord remains or enters into the soul, individual soul, completely occupied, pervade, and he is full in himself. He is complete in himself. But the next question is, if he is complete there, then what remains outside? I mean, nothing is out. That is, he is not present outside. But the scripture says, antar bahishta tatsarva. Therefore, he is everywhere. That is why Brihadaranyaka Upanishad says, when he is complete in one object, he is also complete in another object. That means he is complete in all the objects. He is complete in all the creation. And that we understand by what we call, here we say Muktasya, Muktasya, that is again, he is also, Muktasya is also doing this way, what we call Pritya, Pritya eva. We saw the sentence Pritya eva. What kind of Priti we saw? Then Yatha Shastram. We are going to the word Yatha Shastram. Yatha Shastram according to the science. Then Yatha Avasaram. Yatha Avasaram means what is the opportunity? Avasaraha means opportunity. Tamil Avasaram illa. Tamil Avasaram is emergency. Tamil Avasaram is emergency, but Sanskrit Avasaram is opportunity, chance. So Yatha Avasaram, make hay while the sun shines. When you are blessed with, by the Lord, then you catch hold of that opportunity. So Yatha Avasaram cha. Now the question, previous question was, Varnashrama Dharmanam Lopaha Asyat. That was the problem. Our fear is, when we are singing together in an assembly, we will lose sight of performing the duty perfectly. But it is Yathavasaram Sarvam Gatate. Sarvam, everything, Gatate happens. The word Gatate also denotes that it is miraculously happening. We don't know how it happens. So Sarvam Gatate, so everything happens. Atavasaram, according to the opportunity, then according to Shastra. Anyatha, otherwise. Now the negative example. We have been seeing now positive, so far positive. The next example is Sandhyahinaha Asuchihi Nityam Anarhaha Sarva Karmasu. We must find out where it occurs also. Then Ityadibhihi, maybe in Smriti or Ityadibhihi. Bhagavat Archanat Archanadav. Archanadav api anadikar prasangat. I must help you to separate it while you type. Bhagavat Archanadav. Now the quotation that we see is negative it is not even believed today. It is not cared for. Not cared for. Whatever be the advice of the elders and the sannyasins, in spite of every advice, the Kali Yuga makes us disobey the rules. And that's what we'll blame somebody else. So Bhagavad Archanadav. So in the case of worshipping the Lord. So Bhagavad Archanadav. Api, even while worshipping the Lord, then anadhikara prasangat. We will have no right to take part. We have no right to participate. Anadhikara prasangat. Prasanga is the situation, context in which we have no right, anadhikar. Because we are not supposed to do worship of the God. We are not supposed to do karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga and prapati yoga. We are unfit to do it because we didn't follow the previous rule. He could rule within inverted commas. So sandhyahinaha. So a person who is not doing the daily anushtanam, daily ritual, namely worship of the twilight. Sandhya is twilight. Hinaha means without. A person without the worship of the twilight, morning twilight and evening twilight, and the meridian also, the noon duty, what does he become? Asuchihi, becomes impure. Impure in the sense, We have a word in English also, no? There's a taboo on his participation. Asuchihi. Simply meaning impurity. Then nityam, daily. Yes, we call contaminate. Okay. Is as good as dirty. As good as dirty. Then nityam, forever. Anarghaha, unfit. Sarva karmasu in all the activities. So if I don't do sandhya vandanam, if you don't do twilight worship, I am not fit to participate in kirtanam, that is singing of the names of the Lord. That is basic. Because why is it basic? Everybody is interested in doing it. Many people come together and do it. Nama sankirtanam. That is the only recommendation in Kali Yuga. But in spite of it, we are not to give up our duty. The same problem with the priests in the temple. The temple procedure involves a lot of time, consumes a lot of time, of the individual priest. Either they are doing it collectively or individually. It may affect their schedule every day. So they have to prepone or postpone the, rather preponement is not possible. In English also preponement is not the word. Postponement is to be done. So after coming home from the temple at 9 o'clock at night, he has to perform the sandhyavana. Otherwise he is unfit to become the priest next day. It is also said, when you give up one day's ritual, then you cease to be a Brahmin. You cease to be a spiritual person. You stop. So here, that is the meaning of this one. Many people quote this, and many people are not able to do this sandhya because there are so many reasons behind it also. They are not, some of them are not to be blamed. Those of us who know how to do it, we don't do it. Those who do not know how to do it, they don't do it. Those who know only a little or a few lines extra, they don't do it. So everywhere there is no action. Because it is sandhya hinaha sarva karmasu, then we take it for granted that when we are not doing anything, any twilight worship, then we will not do anything. That is not the right attitude. I think we will take up the next paragraph tomorrow. Yeah.
So Swami, this is a very...
You have to take an elaborate definition of what is Varnashrama Dharma and what. But we are not ready to do it now.
The only
point is interruption of the duties enjoined on us as one belonging to a particular varna and particular ashrama. That is the only point.
Right. So anyway, but the point is that in the Gita, in the ninth chapter of the Gita, 14th verse.
Right.
Yeah, in Gita 9:14, the Satatam Kirtayanto Mam. Satatam means always.
Yeah.
So I had two questions. One is so in North India especially, we see sometimes in temples they do this kirtan, this singing of the names of God, Sita Ram, 24 hours a day. Sometimes they have this akanda right. Kirtana.
Akanda Balaya.
Yeah. So in South India, we don't see this much. People don't do much akanda kirtan.
Yeah, but Smartas do it. And then we have in Srirangam on October 2, Gandhi Jayanti day, they do Akhanda Sahasranama Parayana. by Raghu, BHL Raghu group. Akhanda Sahasranama Parayana.
On Gandhi's of Jayanti.
Gandhi Jayanti Day, because the holiday, today, Corona, every day is holiday. But October 2 is Gandhi Jayanti Day. Whether it is Sunday or any day, it is a holiday, a government holiday. Total, whole India has a holiday. So we do what we call Akhanda Parayana. And we take up August 15th, Independence Day of India, as a day for, one of the 3 days where many of us go to Tirupati and do Akhanda Sahasranama Parayana. Again, Vishnu Sahasranama. There are two aspects, as you know, as you understand. 24 hours, not the same person is continuing for 24 hours. I go there, sit for whatever the time I can do it, say 8 hours, or and come back, take food, and then go again. And so you have got some lot of gap, but there is a continuity of some people saying Sahasranamam continues. That's all. That is what we cannot keep everyone totally for 24 hours and. And then 3 days it is happening. Lot of what they call association, Sahasranama Association, the group are coming in Tirupati.
Sometimes people, you're saying one person cannot physically be there 24 hours, but he has to go and take care of essential work. Here Vedanta Deshikar is saying the essential work. He gives this quotation about doing Sandhya Vandanam. So he means that the essential work should also be the Vanashram duties. So whatever the Vanashram duties are, that is considered essential work. So one should do the kirtan all the time, except for when he has to do the Vanashram duties.
Without interruption to the normal duties.
So also he says the same thing for doing worship of the Lord. The essential duties are like Sandhya Vandanam. But we have this story of Parasara Bhatta. Parasara Bhatta was fanning God with the chamari. And the time for the twilight, as you say, the time for doing Sandhya Vandanam approaches. And people asked him, Swami, you should stop the fanning of God, and you should go to do the twilight Sandhya Vandanam. And he wanted to continue doing the fanning. So is it correct or not? Should we continue doing the fanning, and then afterwards, as you say, when we go at 10 o'clock at night to the house, we do evening Sandhya Vandanam?
Yeah.
But this is not what Vedanta Deshika is saying. Vedanta Deshika is saying you have to break it and go. You have to break the worship and go. Do Sandhya Vandanam.
And that is why he say make a shift, and then there are so many priests in the temple. Each one of us will decide together who should be there for the particular time, and then so a priest after performing earlier the Sandhya Vandanam should attend to the Lord. Whereas others can take some respite.
So, practically in the temple administration, do they have shifts? They have shifts of the priests.
Yeah.
And are the shifts ending and beginning at the time of Sandhya Vandanam?
I don't know exactly, but they have shifts.
But in case there is a problem and somebody doesn't come for the shift, right? If somebody doesn't come for the shift, the archika cannot leave the garbhagriham.
This is where Ramanujacharya gave us stress on these procedures in Koyiluru and Nitya Grantha. He made it so clear that the priest must act according to the procedure laid down by Ramananda.
But also there's a story about Satada Sri Vaishnavas. There's a Satada Sri Vaishnavas that they say that the Satadas previously used to wear the Upavitam, and they were Brahmins, and they used to do Sanya Vandanam, but Ramanuja asked them to do kind karya in the temple, like sweeping and lighting the lamps and fanning and many, many duties. And
making garlands, preparing sandal paste.
Yeah, even in Sri Rangam, the Satada Vidhi is full of people making garlands. Right. So we see that street full of garland makers. But these people have so much kind karya to do, they cannot do the Sandhya Vandanam. So some people say that Ramanuja asked them, told them to, you forget about this, you just do the kind karya. You do the temple worship. Is it correct?
I have not heard so, but the only thing is they have given up the Brahmin hood. They took off the Jignopavitam and threw it out. And therefore they have become Bhagavata. They don't have twilight worship as their duty.
Right. So this Bhagavatas is a nice way of saying that they are non-Brahmins. Just like Gandhi called the Dalits, Harijans. To give a nice name to them, he called them Harijans. We're all Harijans. Yeah. We're all people of God. In Sri Vaishnavism, instead of saying that they are non-Brahmins, you just say they are Satadas.
Bhagavatas,
yeah. Okay, so again, the point is, Vedanta Deshika seems to be saying here, it is more important to go and do the Vanashrama duties than to do the temple worship or even to do the singing of the Lord's name, which is the Yuga Dharma, which is the Dharma for Kali Yuga.
Right.
So I think some people may object to this and they may say, in practical terms, what happens is people do the Satatam Kirtayantamam or they do the Archana. After the Archana is finished, they do Prayaschitta Argya, they do the Sanya Vandanam, but do the Prayaschitta Argya.
Right.
But in this section, Vedanta Deshika seems to say, no, it is better to stop it. Stop the Satatam Kirtayantamam, stop the Akhanda Kirtan, and go and do Sanya Vandanam. Afterwards, you can come back and you can do it again. So my other question about this also is that some Vaishnavacharyas, they say that we should always be thinking of Dwaya Mantram. We should always be meditating on Dwaya Mantram. And even Ramanuja, his last orders to his disciples was, you should always meditate on Dwayam. So this is also Satatam Kirtayantamam. Because you're saying that you do, when you get a free day, like Gandhi Jayanti or the Independence Day for India, you do Sahasranama Parayanam. So what is more important, to do Sahasranama Parayanam or do Dwaya Japa? Should we not be doing Dwaya Japa all the time in the mind? Even externally, we're making flower garlands, but we, in the mind, we should be doing Dwaya Japa, no?
Vishnu Sahasranama is recited by all without any distinction of Varna and Ashram.
But so is Dwayam. Dwayam also.
Dwayam also. Dwayam in the case of Varna and Ashrama, okay, but Varna? Do you have people advised by the preceptors to do Dvaya Japa? You mean the Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Rudra? No.
But I think everybody is advised to do Dvaya. Everybody is, anybody who, Samashrayanam is open to everybody and everybody gets Dvaya Mantram. So should they not? I'm just trying to understand. Okay, so this, the Vishnu Sahasranama is also very important. Dwayam is also very important. So, but I cannot do Dvaya Japa and do Vishnu Sahasranam at the same time. If I'm concentrating on Vishnu Sahasranam, I'm not concentrating on Dvayam. So to me, the Dvayam is more important than Vishnu Sahasranam because it is.
And as I said, only 2 days a year. 2 days a year they arrange the Akhanda Sahasranam. So on that particular day only we are not reciting Dvayam.
You're not reciting Dvayam.
Yeah, I mean, you said if you do recitation of Sahasranamam, then that will hamper our meditation on Dvayam.
Yeah, of course. Mostly people are doing Sandhya Vandanam. They do Gayatri Mantra Japam, and then afterwards they do Astakshara Dvaya Charamastoka Japam, which is the Agamic Sandhya Vandanam. It is the Tantric Sandhya Vandanam. So they do that also. People do that also. I think Hobalamat Shishas are doing Astakshara Mantra 3 times a day. Other people may only be doing 1 time. I'm not sure. But and then Sahasranama, some people are doing Sahasranama every day. And some people are doing Sahasranama only occasionally. What is the correct procedure, Swami?
Some people do
Sahasranamam every single day. Many people are doing Sahasranamam every day. Daily Parayanam of Sahasranamam.
Right.
So when is Sahasranamam to be done in the daily duties? At what time?
Generally we do it in the evening.
In the evening.
Some people do it in the morning also.
But is after Sandhya, after Sayam Sandhya?
After Sandhya. No.
After Sayam Sandhya.
No, after Sayam Sandhya.
Okay.
So only then 2 days of the month, they avoid saying Sahasranamam in the evening. Then they can say in the morning.
There's
Mahapradosham day.
On Pradosham, you should not say Sahasranam in the evening. You should say in the morning.
Mahapradosham, 2 times. Trayodashi Tithi.
Trayodashi Tithi, yeah, in the evening. But so is there a reason why you should not do Sahasranama during Pradosham?
No, yeah. Pradosham, the word Pradosham, dosha defect. Pradosha is greater defect. Great defect. Mahapradosha is very great defect. The defective time is called a defective time because the demons are fighting with this God there every day in the morning to night and evening to night time. And therefore called bad time.
But we understood, we all, okay, but the Narasimha Bhaktas, they like the Pradosham because they think it is a very important, good for Narasimha.
Yeah.
So for Narasimha Bhaktas, it's okay. They can do Sahasranam during Pradosham?
No, on Mahapradosham day, nobody does it.
Nobody should do it. Okay.
Yeah, but suppose you want to do it, you can do it in the heart. It should not be orally heard by others.
Right. But the question is, even Govindacharya is asking the same question. If there is a bad time, if there is an evil time, like Pradosham or like Kuja Dosha, Rahu Kalam, there's a bad time every day,
yeah.
is it not best to do Japam in that time of bad time? Grahanam, we do Japam during Grahanam, during eclipse,
yeah, Japam,
during
Rahu Kalam. Japam in Grahanam is the most required. The condition is you have to do it. Grahanam will give us the thousands of benefits,
right.
Crores of benefits.
Right. So the same. But then why is it different for Pradosham? Pradosham is also a bad time, like Grahanam. We should do. Should we not do Japam during Pradosham?
Yeah, sannyasis remain silent. Sannyasis prefer to remain silent during Mahaprabhu. 4 o'clock evening to 7 o'clock.
Sannyasis remain silent, but maybe they are meditating on Omkar or something. I don't know what sannyasis are doing. As far as the rest of us are concerned, the non-sannyasis.
We are not actually following any vow of silence. Except the sannyasi, we are not supposed to.
Okay.
And of course, the other things are normal. Like evening, we only on Trayodashi evening, called Mahaprodosham. Otherwise, every day has got Pradosham, namely morning Pradosham and evening Pradosham. Morning delight and evening delight. Meeting point between day and
so day. Yeah, the twilight itself is a bad time because in the Sandhyavandanam it says that there are Mahendaras, there are these asuras that attack the sun. Even at noon they attack the sun, but they are unable to. In morning time and evening time we offer the Surya Argya, which is like a missile, which is like a astra, to destroy those demons of Mahendaras that are attacking the sun. But in the noontime, we only offer two argyas or one argya because the sun is more powerful in the noon.
Yeah.
So.
And as Govindachal Swami asked, as you said about him, his question, Rahu Kalam, Yamagandam, and Kulikan.
Gulikan,
yeah.
Yamagandam.
All the three are the best time for repeating the God names.
The best times for japa, yeah. So also he is saying maybe people are doing the Vishnu Sahasranama in the evening because they have work during the day and there's a constraint of them because they have works to do in the day.
Right.
So we do Gayatri Japa and offering of Surya Argya, Gayatri, because of the Pradosham times. So these Sandhyas, is there not also a fourth Sandhya in midnight?
Why midnight?
See, in the morning there is a Sandhya when the sun is coming up. In the evening there's a Sandhya when the sun is going down.
Right.
In the noon, the sun is going from one side to the other side.
Right.
But in the middle of the night, there's a fourth Sandhya. Some tantrics are doing something in the night.
No, though the Sandhya, the word Sandhya refers to three times. Only two times is Sandhya. It includes noon. Include noon, but there is no Sandhya at midnight.
Right. So actually, morning and evening are the more important, and noon is not a real Sandhya, because the sun
it's
is
not called Sandhya, but the Lord called it three types of, but it's not real Sandhya.
Okay.
So again, in the meeting point between the forenoon and the afternoon.
Right.
No, only daytime.
Okay, good. Okay.
Sandhi, it's a junction. Sandhi.
The junction, yeah. So that was very interesting class by very interesting point by Vivekananda Deshika. I don't know if anybody else has any questions about that, but I have very much enjoyed this class. And we can see the last sloka is here.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it seems to me that this, what I said about the Charama sloka, the last one is really the Charama sloka, because this one seems to be just a ending sloka.
Yeah. It's only a
glorification. It's like a Mahapyam. It's a Mahapyam.
Yeah.
Right?
Palashruti.
Correct.
कवितार्किक सिंहाय कल्याण गुणशालिने श्रीमते वेंकटेशाय वेदांत गुरवे नमः